Kuzzampola. Namaste, good morning to all respected online viewers. Long live their majesties, long live our leaders, and long live our friendship. Welcome to this online Ayurveda and Yoga workshops, Embassy of India, Thimphu, ICCR's Nehru Wangchuk Culture Center, Yoga teacher, I'm KVSSN Murthy here. My true prayers to the Almighty to see all the best things to their majesties in the whole Bhutan. So before recitation, again, I would like to give stress on these important practices for this COVID, the COVID protocols. Even though you are taking vaccinations, don't forget this kind of physical distancing, safe physical distancing. So if possible, try to avoid crowding. If not possible, try to follow this safe physical distancing while covering your total facial organs. So it is better to use spectacles also when if you have that powerless glasses. Because recent study is saying that the viral cells may enter through the eyes and through the ears also. It may chances. So that always try to cover your facial organs properly. Next one is do not count currency as well as don't count papers by touching your tongue. And always try to follow this kind of hand hygiene and respiratory hygiene. So best thing is try to wash your hands with soap water. If it is not available, now carry your hand lotions. So whenever it is possible, then thoroughly wash your, clean your hands. So next one is our respiratory hygiene. So we have two important oils called Anu Taila or Shatbindu Taila, or if these oils not available, you can use plain cow ghee also to installing these nasal drops inside the nostrils morning once and evening once. It will cover the, like it will give what we call positive effect at the mucus level. Especially for the people who are having this snoring problem, or for them also, it is very simple technique to get rid of that problem. Next one is gargling. Using hot water, acceptable hot water, while using plain salt or estimadu powder or tripala powder, just clean the throat while adding these two, water and powders. Or if it is not available, try to add only salt in the hot water to clean the throat. So next one is steam inhalation is very, very important practice in these days. So in a day, according to the requirement, you can go for 5 times or 6 times or even 10 times also, because hot water cannot kill the viral cells, as hot air can kill the viral cells and bacterial cells, which will be hidden in the paranasal or parasinal cavities inside. So it is very important technique, especially for the people who are regularly visiting outside. For them, it may be very useful technique. So whenever you are getting into the home, just outside of the door, put this device of steam inhalation, and after refreshing yourself through this steam inhalation, then only please enter your home. Next one is 6 to 8 hours of sleep required. 1 more hour may required if you are more active in your regular efforts. Next one is close therapy. Close powder plus honey, adding of hot water or milk morning once, evening once, or at least morning once. It is also good practice to get rid of many throat level disorders, especially caused by the excess of mucus, excess of phlegm. And home Ayurveda or home kitchen remedies called rock salt, pepper, hing, coriander, cumin, jaggery, and honey, turmeric, and cordyceps and shilajit, ilachi, and ajwain powder, and hing, esophagita, all these are very simple and effective home remedies in your regular diet practices. Please thoroughly use these ingredients also. For the general health sake, try to reduce the sugars as well as try to reduce the salts. Drink more hot water in a day, that according to your need, according to your requirement. Especially immediately after food, do not drink more water. But before food, it can be advised to drink water. At least it is a better solution for internal cleaning also. So also we have simple ingredients in the kitchen as well as in the outside in the markets, called pumpkin seeds, red pepper, dark chocolates. Dark chocolate is only mood makers. According to your need, you can use this dark chocolate therapy also, and mushrooms and yogurt and broccoli and berries, wheat grass, and what we call these local green leafy vegetables. And please thoroughly have them in your food, because it is having vitamin A and D and zinc based diets. So this is also good technique to boost up the immunity. And coming to recitation, this recitation from Hatha Yoga Pradipika, sacred yogic text, it is saying that Kshaya Kusta Guda Varta Gulma Ajirna Purogamaha Tasya Dosa Tasya Dosha Kshayam Yanti Maha Mudrantu Yo Bhyaset. It is clearly mentioned that whatever the lung disorders or abdominal disorders, lower abdominal disorders or intestinal disorders or somewhat endometrium disorders, as well as the skin related issues and the Kegel region issues, these disorders will be totally eradicated by the proper practices of Maha Mudra practice. It was given in the Hatha Yoga Pradipika, very simple and easy technique, but somewhat it will go to advanced technicals because it having like a breath holding techniques as well as abdominal absorbing inside, like kind of bandha abhyasas also. After pranayam, after yoga postures pranayam, these techniques will come after in this row, first asana, and after that pranayam, and after that mudra and bandha. So when you are getting into the yoga practices, when you have good interaction with your yoga teacher, please try to take various practices on regarding mudras and bandhas and more notes also regarding these things. So how it will be helpful to the body in therapeutical way as well as for the general health also. So in this week, I would like to give some of the Ayurveda notes and yoga practices for the endometriosis. So endometriosis is a kind of yoni vyapatu in Ayurveda. Yoni vyapatu means it's a unwanted growth of the endometrium inside organs. So this is also because of artava dosha as well as sukra or rajo dhatu vikari. Basically, the causes of this one is autoimmune disorders or as well as family history or heredity or genes and hormonal disturbances and inactive life and frequent infections and some of the drug interferences and especially family background and infections because of yeast and infections because of some other bacterial causes. Then also it is because of internal cancers also. Characteristics are prolonged menstruation, abdominal pain and pelvic pain and lower back pain and general weakness and after that diarrhea, nausea and chronic fatigue and after that frequent infections. So these are some of the characteristics like overbleeding or overbleeding also important characteristics because of this endometriosis. Once you will have this kind of situation, please try to lower the carbohydrates as well as lower the salts also. And try to avoid high fat diets and try to avoid non-vegetarians for at least 3 to 4 months time till you will get better. And try to avoid caffeine also, especially caffeine interference also may create this kind of damage or it will aggregate the actually situation. Next one is some of the foods influenced by the dioxin. It's a kind of pesticides. Avoid these kind of foods also which are already influenced by the pesticides. So next one is try to take more foods which are having more fiber and as well as try to take more hot water with adding of turmeric every time. This is a simple thing. So today, for this situation in Ayurveda way of approach, we have very good medicines called Shatavari root powder, Ashoka bark powder, as well as aloe vera also very good practice for this kind of situation, and turmeric, and Laduka is a kind of tree, and Kalyana Ghrita, and Tankana or Vanga Basma, Chandra Prabhavati, Kravyadi Rasa, and Prajanantaka Loha, Prajanantaka Churna both, and Kanchanala Gugulu. So these are some of the names in Ayurveda. These every name related to one specific tree and one specific species in the plant kingdom. And it is that how you are using this kind of medicines, that is the matter. So anyone can be all right in just 2 months to 3 months time because of this endometriosis. And especially here in today we will see these very simple applications, home remedies for this same situation. One is Asafoetida. Take only 2 grams of Asafoetida and add a turmeric. Asafoetida, turmeric with a 100 ml of water. Early in the morning, empty stomach, use this practice. So this practice you like please use this practice once in a day, that is in the morning. Asafoetida, hing plus turmeric. Then second one is aloe vera pulp and again turmeric. Turmeric is a common ingredient. Please remember aloe vera and turmeric, and using of again 100 ml of water, 20 grams of aloe vera pulp, fresh pulp. If you have fresh pulp, that is more advisable. And adding into the water and adding the turmeric also. This is also good preparation once in the morning, that is early morning, empty stomach. So next one is a Tripala combination. A combination of three Indian medicated plant-based fruits, and Tripala powder and honey. This is also wonderful preparation. You can use this preparation morning once and evening once, adding 10 grams of Tripala powder and honey, using of 100 ml of water morning once and evening once. These three are today's important but simple practices. But please remember, our inactive life also a big cause of invite to many kind of disorders and diseases. So that my requesting is try to please adopt more active hobbies which will make you active. So your hobbies will make you always active. Please remember that, do not try to master in any kind of hobby, but try to adopt more hobbies and be very busy in your schedules, as well as try to lead a life of stress-free life. This is also a very important factor. When we are meeting here at the same place, same topic tomorrow, we will see still more good applications in Ayurveda. And let's do for yoga class now. And in yoga, as we know that every yoga exercise has its own important and its own impact to create health balance on the body. But it is the participants' requirement, it's the participants' interest how they are doing. Suppose just now I'm now practicing sun salutations. It is also a complete package of yoga exercises. It has nearly 12 posters. Each poster has a different kind of dimension to twist the body, to turn the body, to bend the body, to squeeze the body. So it is the people how we are doing and what you are doing, at what level you are practicing. When you have time for direct interaction with your yoga teacher, please take some more good notes on this same endometriosis and the yoga also. But today I'm now doing a regular yoga practices for the sake of all. Today's yoga practices not only meant for the people who are having this endometriosis or this kind of issues. This will be beneficial for the all people. Right. Coming to the practices, take a long deep inhalation and exhalation, and after that lift your arms completely up and pranamasana above to the head called Kailasha Mudra. Then slowly bring your Kailasha Mudra at your heart region called Anahata Pranamasana. Take a long slow inhalation exhalation. So here we have mantra chanting and sloka and Bijakshara. When you have your traditional belief, then you can follow these practices or you can follow only the physical exercises. Okay, long slow deep inhalation and exhalation, then after that Om Hiranmayena Patrena Satyasyapi Hitam Mukham Tatvam Pushan Apavrunu Satya Dharmaya Drushtaye. Om Hram Hrim Hrum Hraim Hraum Raha मित्र रवि सूर्य भानु कग पूष्ण हिरण्य गर्भ मरीच आदित्य सवित्र अर्क भास्कराय नमः. And stretch your arms completely forward, then open the arms, lift the arms up, hasta uttanasana. So once pull yourself up from there, slightly put a back bend, ardha chandrasana or ardha chakrasana, and keep your body straight. Again, pull yourself up. And when you have lower back issues or blood fluctuations or heart ailments or ear problems or head level issues, though, do not apply these practices, then remaining people can bend the body up to their flexibility. And right leg is your back leg now. Aswa Sanchalanasana or horse riding posture. And back leg straight on the toes and join your forward leg to back leg called Dandasana or Santulanasana. Alright, bend the body completely forward towards the floor called Ashtanga Namaskarasana. Your forehead or chin, your two palms and chest and your knees, your toes must come down on the floor. And push your body completely forward. After that, like a sea wave, lift the body to attach your body towards your lifted head, cobra posture or bhujangasana. And back leg straight on the toes. And very slowly push your body inside. And try to press your heels down towards the floor called parvatasana or mountain triangular posture. And right leg will be your forward leg again, Aswa Sanchalanasana, horse riding posture. And back leg straight on the toes and join your back leg to forward leg called Padahastasana. Alright, lift your arms and the body completely up and keep pull once. Then from there slightly put a back bend. Then very slowly attach your body for again Hasta Uttanasana and Pranayamasana. Then very slowly bring your Pranayamasana at your chest level. Then after that, lift your arms with inhalation and with exhalation, wide your both the hands. Then very slowly bring them together down at your thighs. And after that, slowly keep your legs in a proper distance away and lock your hands back and keep your body straight and have your healthy breath. Then coming to the next exercise. So last week also we did Pavana Mukta Asana Sreni, a kind of warm-up techniques in the yoga. Today also we will do the same set of exercises what we did last week, because that is somewhat relevant to the practices, relevant to the people who are having these abdominal issues, especially the endometrium and as well as PCOD issues. Alright, and now properly sit on the any surfaces. So like you can choose any flat surface that may be on the bed or on the floor or on the mat. So be very convenient wherever you are sitting. Okay, just take a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. Then here, keep your body straight and take a long, slow, deep inhalations and exhalations. So now we are doing the same hip practices as well as spinal twists. And fold your right leg. Then completely fold with breathe out, slightly press the abdomen, then slowly stretch your leg again open with breathe in. Again completely breathe out, fold and press the abdomen, then completely stretch and wide. Last count, breathe out, fold, then very slowly breathe in, stretch. Just take a long slow inhalation. And opposite side, same exercise, completely breathe out, fold and breathe in, stretch. Again, breathe out, fold, and slowly breathe in, stretch. So last count, breathe out, fold. Again, very slowly breathe in, stretch. Then here, slowly take a relax from the practices. Long, deep, slow inhalations and exhalations. Alright, keep your body straight. Take again, long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalation. And fold your right leg, flat fold, like a half lotus. Then here also, once lift your knee up, slightly press the abdomen with breathe out and slowly come down to normal. But press the knee towards the floor as well as lift the knee up, breathe out, then slowly come down. So last count, breathe out, press the abdomen and breathe in completely down and relaxations enough, straight the leg. And opposite side, same exercise, breathe out, fold the leg. Then here also, once completely lift the thigh up to press the abdomen, again very slowly press the thigh down. Again lift the knee up, breathe out, again press the knee down. Last count, lifts and then very slowly come back and down, resting, relaxation. Long, slow inhalations and exhalations. And fold your right leg properly. Then after that we are doing hip rotation. So every time try to press the abdomen also while doing this one. Alright, breathe out, lift your knee and slowly breathe in, down. Again, breathe out, lift the knee, and slowly breathe in down. Last count, breathe out, lift the knee, then very slowly breathe in down. Opposite side, same thing, then breathe out, then very slowly come back, breathe in. Second count, breathe out, and very slowly come back, breathe in. Last count, breathe out, then slowly come back. All right, breathe in, then open the leg. Just few seconds, break. Long, slow, and deep inhalations and exhalations. Then opposite side, same practice, fold your leg. Then try to properly catch like your ankle with your opposite side hand and keep your leg structure like a half lotus. Then after that, lift your knee with breathe out, then slowly come back, so breathe in. And second count, breathe out, then slowly come back, breathe in. Third, last count, so breathe out and come back, so breathe in. Opposite side, same thing, breathe out and slowly come back. Second count, breathe out, then slowly come back. Last count, breathe out, lift your knee and then slowly come back, release the tension, then very slowly open the leg and relaxation. And few seconds, rest your back in Dandasana or Sukha Dandasana. Long, slow, deep inhalations and exhalations. Alright, again, keep your body straight and long, slow, deep inhalations and exhalations. So here we have one simple exercise. This is for actually pelvic stretch and called butterfly movement. So according to your convenience, keep your heels completely closer to the perineal region and move your knees like a butterfly wings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, then enough, 10. So your hands must come down on the knees to press your knees more to stretch your pelvic, then very slowly come back. Second count to stretch, then come back. Last count, while stretching, keep your both the hands straight, then try to keep your both your shoulders also lift towards your neck region and stay for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, resting, relaxation. Soon after that, again fold your two legs, then put your heels inside. Just try to press your abdomen with your both the knees and few seconds stay now. So this is itself will create somewhat pressure or sensitive pressure at your abdominal level, and stay few seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, then very slowly stretch your legs, then slowly come back to normal. Again few seconds, rest your back like in back bending, lift your chest and expand your chest and lift your rib cage and hang your head and stay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then relaxations, enough, long deep inhalations and exhalations. All right, keep your body straight, take a long deep inhalation, exhalation. Then we are doing boat rowing as a last exercise. Today's last exercises, it related to hips, related to spine, related to abdomen also. But when you have lower back issues or mid back issues, do not immediately choose this kind of exercises and take care of your convenience. Okay, long, slow, deep inhalations and exhalations. All right, lift your both the arms up, then slightly pull the body back. After that, push the body forward like a boat rower. Just arm movement should be like boat rower. Lift your arms, then very slowly exhalation down, then again lift your arms, then again exhalation down. Last count, lift your arms and exhalations down, relaxation. Then same here, opposite side, then push your body forward, lift your arms, inhalation, then slowly come back and wide your arms. Again push your body with breathe out, breathe in, wide and spread your hands. Last count, push and then very slowly pull back. Then very slowly rest your hands, relaxations, enough. Again, slightly wide your hands and just few seconds, feel that stretch out, breathe in, breathe out. Long, deep inhalations and exhalations. In this same boat rowing practices, we have another exercise called pedal boat rowing. So here also, like in this exercise, in this next exercise, no need to bend your body, but bend your knees while keeping the hand movement will be same. 1, breathe out and slowly stretch, breathe in. Again, breathe out and come back, breathe in. Again, third count, breathe out, breathe in. Fourth count, breathe out, breathe in. Last count, breathe out, then very slowly come back, rest your hands again.
Again, few seconds break. Again, few seconds, keep your both the legs wide. Lift your ribcage and expand your chest. Long, deep, slow inhalations and exhalations. Then and straight, keep your body straight. Next one is cross boat rowing. Wide your right leg to the right side. Then fold your left leg. Again, still if you want create a space, still you can create a space between your two legs. Here one leg is vertical fold and one is stretch flat but to the exact cross side. Alright, and now lift your arms towards your open leg side, bend, then very slowly come back with breathe in. Again, breathe out, stretch, then come back, breathe in. Again, third, last count, breathe out, stretch, breathe in, then come back. Opposite side, same thing, breathe out, then slowly come back, breathe in. Second count, breathe out and come back. Then last count, breathe out, then very slowly come back. Then very slowly keep your both the hands and very slowly legs together. Soon after that, just fold your legs towards your right side, towards your left side. Just go for your spine turns and knee turns and hip stretches. And one, so here stay on any side to give more relaxation on the hip level. One, two, three and four, come back. Opposite side, same exercise. One, two, three, then relaxations enough. Then stretch your both the legs. And long, slow inhalation. Then same exercise, opposite side. And here, wide your two legs, especially open your left leg still far left. Fold your right leg. So here, create a maximum distance between your two legs if you can and if you want. Then same thing here, cross boat rowing. Lift your arms with exhalation, bend. And slowly come back, breathe in. Again, breathe out, bend, then slowly come back, breathe in. Third, last count, breathe out, then slowly come back. Opposite side, same practice, breathe out and lift and very slowly come back. Second count, breathe out and very slowly come back. Third, last count, breathe out and then slowly come back. All right, relax your hands and rest your two legs. Then soon after that, fold your two legs. Again, go for just post stretches. Turn your knees and turn your hips, just relax your knees and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 relaxation. So today is our last practice also related to boat rowing. Here what we call lifted leg boat rowing. So keep your right heel on the left toes. Keep your right heel on the left toe. Just check the distance and check your convenience. Then while lifting your arms and while bending the body, take care, especially above, to the above back. But while bending the body, lift your above leg also with breathe out. One, then slowly keep your body straight, leg down. Then second count, two, then come back. Three, come back. Four, come back. Last counts, five, then very slowly come back. No need to stay in any posture, no need to arrest your breath also. Once rest your leg, again, slant your body, just take a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. Again, here, same exercise, opposite sides. Choose proper way of keeping your one, like alternate leg heel, left heel on the right toes and body straight. Then we are doing same exercise, lift the arms. Again, breathe out, one, then slowly come back, breathe in. Two, breathe out and come back, breathe in. Three, breathe out, come back, breathe in. Four, breathe out and come back, breathe in. Last count, breathe out and very slowly come back with breathe in. Keep your hands down and relax your leg. Again, rest your back in the Sukha Dandasana or lifted chest posture, and lift your chin and hang your head back. Just take a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalations. All right, keep your body straight. Then long, slow inhalation, exhalation. So in this Pavana Mukta Asana Srini, we have many other exercises also. When we have time in coming days, then we will do remaining exercises also from the format of Pavana Mukta Asana Srini or Sukshma Yoga Vyayam. And for today, let's coming to the Pranayama. So soon after your yoga postures, physical exercises, if you have time, so try to create some time, some gap, to drink a sip of water, not more water, sip of water. It is actually advised to do the same water drinking in a special way of method as mentioned in Hatha Yoga Pradipika for the mantra chanting and sloka chanting. According to your traditional belief, you can choose mantra, sloka, or you can choose only physical exercises. So today also we have practices of Kapalabhati, Bhastrika, as well as Ujjayi Pranayam. Basically, the people who are having this kind of abdominal issues, for them some of the practices required which will give the cooling effect inside the body. But please remember to avoid some of the foods which will create heat inside. Some people having the same kind of heat sensation with the spicy things, heat sensation with the pepper, and heat sensation with the some of the red meat and non-vegetarians. Please try to avoid those foods from your diet. Okay, and now choose any convenient comfortable posture, lotus or half lotus, or any convenient posture, or you can sit on the chair, or you can sit on the bed, or if you have back issues, you can choose wall or chair for your back as a supporter. So right, take a long slow inhalation exhalation. So here we have mantra chanting and sloka, then pranamasana here again. Om Kesavaya Swaha, Om Madhavaya Swaha, Om Narayanaya Swaha, Om Adya Samadhi Tatpala Siddhyardham Asana Purvakan Pranayamadin Karishye. Om Sandhi Sandhi Sandhi. So in other words, it has mentioned that practices in yoga postures or pranayama breathing exercises, or some of the breath holding techniques or kriyas body cleaning techniques, as well as meditations, and all these practices purpose is to keeps us travel towards the spiritual upliftment. Okay, now coming to the next exercise is called Kapalabhati and Ujjayi Pranayam, as well as Bhastrika Pranayam. So let's start with the Kapalabhati. As we know, Kapalabhati mentioned, it has mentioned in traditional textbooks called Bastrava Loha Karasya Recha Purav Sasambhramav Kapalabhatir Vikyata Kapadosha Visoshini. So phlegm related errors will be totally eradicated because of this Kapalabhati sadhan. But the people who are having these blood pressure issues or heart ailments or ear problems or any other sickness, better to take advice from your physician, as well as better to choose a good yoga teacher also who can give good notes on this medical yoga concepts. So next one is Ujjayi Pranayam. This is very important pranayam. It is also saying that Slashma Dosha Haram Kante Dehanala Vivardhanam Nadi Jalodhara Dhatu Gata Dosha Vinasanam. It is also saying that phlegm level errors will be eradicated, which already deposited at the throat levels. Next one is, it's saying that Dehanala Vivardhanam means Anala means here Agni. Agni means is a kind of digestive fire, or we can call it as a metabolic activities or immunity also. Nadi Jalodhara Dhatu Gata Dosha Vinasanam. Whatever errors inside, in between the seven important body running factors, Dhatus, what Rasa, Rakta, Mamsa, Maida, Asthi, Majja, and Sukra. So here body fluids and blood fluids, muscular tissues, adipose tissues, as well as bone marrow, bone tissues and bone marrow. The next one is gonadal tissues. These are important dhatus inside. So in between these seven dhatu also, there must be one balance. Through this simple pranayam, that balance will begin in running or in coordinate with these seven important running factors. The next one is Ida, Pingala, Sushumna, Hasti Jihva, Pusha, Asashwini, Alambusha, and Kuhu. And the next one is Shakini. The next one is Vajra. These are the important pranic pravaha flow, pranic flow channels, which is invisible but is very important running factors inside. This kind of Ujjayi pranayam also will create some of the harmony and balance between this pranic pravaha flow also. So once pranic pravaha flow will be all right, once saptadhatu will be all right, then there will be no issues inside, especially Vata, Pitta, Kapha will be organizing or is being organized by these Sapta Dhatus or this important 10 important Pranic Pravaha channels. As next one is Bhastrika, also a kind of pranayam. This is saying that Vata, Pitta, Slashma, Haram, Sarir, Agni, Vivardhanam, Kundali, Bodhakam, Kshupram, Pavanam, Sukadam, Hitam, Brahma, Nadi, Mukhe, Samasta, Kapadhyargala, Nasanam. Like it is saying that in between the internal wind, internal bile and internal mucus, the Bhastrika Pranayam will bring some positive changes. It is also saying that Sarir Agni Vivardhanam, again another way of practice through Bhastrika, it is also kind of uplifter of immunity as well as uplifter of metabolic activities or digestive fire. But the people who are doing yoga practices or tantric practices or mantra practices or prayers to awakening the internal dormant energies or to awakening the intuitions, for them also Bhastrika is a usable practice. But please remember, Bhastrika Pranayam will create some of the heat inside. This is not really applicable for everyone, but it will be you can use this as a sub practice to create harmony at the lungs as well as in between Vata, Pitta, Kapha. But the way how we are doing also important. Okay, let's start our Kapala Bhati first. Sharp exhalation, slow inhalations. Keep your body straight. Or you can hold your knees also with your palms to erect your spine. Alright, take long, slow, deep inhalations, exhalations. We are doing Kapala Bhati, sharp exhalation, slow inhalation. Then starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Just take a long inhalation, exhalation. Then coming to second spell, starting our same Kapala Bhati. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, deep, long inhalation and exhalation. And third, last spell, Kapala Bhati. Then starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. Then after that, few seconds break. So this is Kapala Bhati is a Kriya Abhyasa or cleaning technique, especially frontal brain cleaning technique. So it is better to give more importance at the abdominal level stroke rather than breath stroke. So many people are giving the kind of sound at the breathe outs. That is also good, but more than that, concentrate on the abdomen. How you are moving the abdomen is a important factor here. Factor is try to hit the abdomen inside, but do not push the abdomen out. But very slowly release the abdomen out after the stroke making. Okay, now next exercise, completely opposite side to this Kriya Abhyas, Kapala Bhati. Generally it is called as a Bhastrika Pranayam. It's a sharp inhalation, slow exhalation. Right, keep your body straight by holding your knees with your palms, or you can turn your palms, or you can put your chin mudra by adding your thumb to index finger. Keep your body straight. Now starting our exercise, 1, then slowly come back. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, last counts, 10. Just long, slow inhalation, exhalation. Sharp inhalation called Bhastrika. Sharp exhalation called Kapala Bhati. Again, we are doing the same Bhastrika, sharp inhalation strokes. Starting again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Just again, long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalations. Alright, last stroke making, towards 30th stroke we are doing. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10. Just again, long, slow and deep inhalation, exhalation. Then small break. After that, we are doing Ujjayi Pranayam. It is a kind of voluntary a sound making from the throat level. It's what we call baby snoring sound. It is very easily we can create the sound while inhalation, because that inhalation air should hit the throat walls or internal nostril walls. It has to create a kind of snoring sound. It's an intentional snoring sound while inhalation, while exhalation without making any sound, regular exhalation. But for these two practices, no need to open the mouth. Close your mouth and you can do this practices very simple. So to cover the practices, now I'm requesting my video technician come forward to cover the sound only. Okay, just take a long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalation. So for your awareness and for your understanding, you can put your right hand finger or left hand finger just under the throat, that kind of junction. Like while inhalation, slightly you can press them. But this hand structure not really required. But the people who wants to begin good understanding, for them only it may useful. Okay, now coming to practices. First, keep your finger at your throat level. Alright, then after that, slightly press the throat while inhalation, then you can observe easily the kind of snoring while inhalation, starting here. Breathe out, while breathe out, hand down, the regular breathe out with the nostrils. Then again, begin sound making while inhalation by pressing your throat. Then very slowly, hand down, long, slow inhalation, exhalation. Then same thing, third inhalation. Then very slowly, exhalation. Fourth count, inhalation again. And then slowly come back, breathe out with the nostrils. Last count, inhalation. Then slowly come back while breathing out. So while attempting this kind of practices, one can easily getting some discomfort while breathing. Immediately they will cough or somewhat they will struggle for the breath. So at that case, immediately keep the hand down, then please take regular inhalation, exhalation. But very slowly adopt this kind of methods. Okay, once you will finish your the total pranayam, and if you know well about the dharana practices, you can choose dharana practices by concentrating your mind in the mentioned manner at the eyebrow center. Or you can choose any concentration practices from the Trataka format, Trataka practices. So once you will able to successfully finish the dharana or Trataka practices, now you can take some more time to take rest to the body through yoga nidra or through power nap. Then based on the intensity in the practices, based on the strength levels in the practices, it is also advised to take 15 minutes to half an hour time. Some people may take half an hour time also to take bath, and from there further 10 minutes time to take breakfast. And in the afternoon, before your lunch hour, try to see all the possibilities to take a power nap or to do yoga nidra. It will rejuvenate the body and mind. It will give good levels of the concentration to focus on your further works. Basically, it will improve your productivity towards the works. Then in the evening, once you will totally free from your all efforts and activities, and before your dinner time, try to create at least half an hour time to do self yoga practices, including back bending exercises and including inverted postures, as well as including breathe in and breathe out, pranayam also. And especially while in the sleep time, do not get disturbed or do not get spoil your sleep because of any external sounds or any external activities. And tomorrow when we are meeting here at the same time, same topic, with the same content, we will see still more good applications in Ayurveda and good exercises in yoga also. So until then, take care of yourself, stay away from the bad habits and do yoga also. Thanking you all.